Hello and welcome to The Big Story, where we discuss the top news of today and explain why it matters. I'm Haryanto Diman, coming to you live from the Straits Times newsroom. Following the death of former ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, a new successor may have been appointed. Now, the new leader is thought to be this man, Abu Ibrahim al-Hashimi al-Quraishi. Now, very little is known about him. Meanwhile, closer to home, many experts do not believe the threat posed by ISIS has diminished in any way, as Indonesia and the Philippines are known hotbeds for Islamic extremist ideology. As this US Bureau Chief Nirmal Ghosh spoke to our correspondents there to find out more. Now, here are the key highlights from his own show, The Asian Insider.
So let's turn now to Wahyudi Suryatmadja, the Straits Times Indonesia correspondent in Jakarta, and Raul Dansil, Philippines correspondent in Manila. Wahyudi, thanks for being with us today. What is your assessment of the influence of ISIS in Indonesia?
Indonesia, the largest Muslim population in the world. And ISIS, they have been having this, what they call Takfiri doctrine. They treat anyone as enemies, including Muslims who do not follow their doctrine. If I can tell you more, compared to Jemaah Islamiyah, ISIS attacks have been small, poorly planned, unorganized. So we can call they are just newbie terrorists with lack of experience. They have picked up their skills to attack primarily from internet. And unlike Jemaah Islamiyah, they don't have people who have gone to battles in Afghanistan, in Mindanao. There are a lot of lone wolves. And if Baghdadi died, the ISIS newsletter would report it like they did when the ISIS spokesman Abu Muhammad al-Atmani died and ISIS announced he was replaced by Ali Muhajir. So basically, they're saying a replacement of ISIS leader would confirm the demise of al-Baghdadi. And they also went on, if Baghdadi was killed, there will be a successor. Don't worry. So these are the chatters among the militants on the social media. So their violent jihad will continue regardless.
Very, very interesting. Okay, so Raul, coming to the Philippines, what is your take? Do you think al-Baghdadi's demise will resonate out there, will change anything there?
I agree with the assessment of security officials here that the Baghdadi's death, while a setback, will not diminish the threat of violent extremism here in the Philippines. I think one fact to look at here is that Baghdadi, in the eyes of his followers, Baghdadi died a martyr. And this is bound to galvanize younger, more idealistic terrorists here in the Philippines. I'd like to point out that here in the Philippines, we've had suicide attacks before, but they were perpetrated by foreigners, you know, Indonesians. In the last bombing, we had a couple from Indonesia who bombed a cathedral here in southern Philippines. But in July, we saw the first case of a Filipino suicide bomber. No, and I think Baghdadi's death, the way it happened, he blew himself up, I understand. It's setting an example, you know, for younger, more idealistic Filipino terrorists. And that may embolden them to, you know, resort to more suicide attacks. And we've had an influx of foreign terrorists coming here. No? And they're the ones who are radicalizing these younger generation of Muslims. No? And so to sum it up, I think Baghdadi's death will just galvanize these terrorists.
Well, here in the United States, General Kenneth McKenzie, commander of the U.S. Central Command, or CENTCOM, has been quite frank that nobody is under any illusions. We don't see a bloodless future, he said, because al-Baghdadi will be replaced and that ideology is still out there.
Do catch the full episode of The Asian Insider on the Straits Times YouTube channel.